हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ जे विनय कुमार एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न ऑन डीसी मशीन्स एंड बैटरीज। इन द प्रीवियस प्रेजेंटेशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी discussed about losses in DC motors, that is the copper losses, which is also called as variable losses, and these copper losses mainly occur in armature windings and shunt field winding, and also in series field windings. And the other type of loss is constant losses. These constant losses are classified into two types. One is eddy current losses, and the other is hysteresis losses. And there are also some other types of losses which will be very small in percentage. Those losses includes windage losses, sway load losses, and also friction losses, that is between friction between the shaft and bearing. And also we have studied about the power stages in DC motors in a DC motor the input will be electrical power and the output will be the torque at the shaft, which we call it as shaft torque. And we have also learned about the calculations of losses and efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but it is the ratio of output to the input. and we have studied various efficiencies such as electrical efficiency and also mechanical efficiency. And we have solved some problems on efficiency. And in this presentation, we are going to learn about the electrical and mechanical characteristics of DC series motor, and also we'll be learning these characteristics of DC shunt motors. Now let us see the characteristics of DC motors. First of all, let us see about the electrical characteristics or armature torque. We also call it as gross torque. Nothing but it is the torque developed in the armature, and IA, nothing but it is the armature current characteristics. And we will be studying about the speed represented by N and armature current IA characteristics. After that, we'll be learning about the mechanical characteristics or N versus TA characteristics. First of all, we will be learning about the characteristics of DC series motor. In that, the first one is electrical characteristics. And this electrical characteristics is between the armature torque and armature current. From the previous torque equations, we know that the armature torque or gross torque is directly proportional to the flux phi and armature current IEA. But whereas in a series motor, the armature current IA and series field current ISC will be same, because in series motor the field and armature are connected in series. So the current will be directly proportional to flux phi. This is up to the point of magnetic saturation. Up to saturation, the flux phi will be directly proportional to IA. Before magnetic saturation, the torque, that is the armature torque, will be proportional to IA square. At low loads, that is at light load, the torque will be proportional to the square of the armature current. And the shape of this curve will be parabola. Means if we draw the characteristics between armature torque and armature current, then the shape of the curve will be parabola. Now let us see the curve between these two. Here the y-axis represents the armature torque, and the x-axis will be drawing the armature current. If we draw a curve between these two, curve will be like this. Here at light loads it will be like this, and after that it will be almost linear. And this represents the gross torque or armature torque. And here the dotted line represents the shaft टॉर्क रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय टी एस एच. At high loads, due to field current, the field coils get saturated and the flux remains constant. When flux will be constant, the armature torque will be directly proportional to only armature current. We have seen there at light loads, the armature torque will be directly proportional to Ia square, whereas at high loads, as the field current gets saturated, so the flux becomes constant, so the TA will be directly proportional to IA. And I have already shown this in the curve. During the initial values, the armature torque will be directly proportional to Ia square, but at high loads it will be directly proportional to Ia only. So here the curve becomes a straight line. We know that the shaft torque will be always less than the armature torque. This we have already studied in the previous presentations. The armature torque is nothing but it is the torque developed in the armature. And the shaft torque is the torque available at the shaft. Okay. The armature torque minus shaft torque is equal to loss torque. In the curve, the dotted line represents the shaft torque. And series motors have more initial torque during starting because the armature torque is directly proportional to square of the current. So such type of motors are used in traction purpose and also in hoists. Now let us see the other type of characteristics drawn between N and IA. We know that N, that is speed, is directly proportional to EB by phi, where EB is the back EMF, and phi is the flux. And the back EMF is given as V minus IA RA. So the speed N is proportional to V minus IA RA by phi. So in a series motor, when the load current is varied, IARA also gets varied. But as the variation of IARA can be neglected because this is very, very small when compared with the supply voltage. So we neglect IRA. Hence, EB may be treated as constant. If EB is constant, N will be proportional to 1 by phi. And we also know that the speed of the series motor varies inversely as armature current, because flux is directly proportional to IA. From this, N is inversely proportional to IA. Speed N is inversely proportional to IA. So if we draw a curve between the speed N and armature current IA, then we get a curve, and the shape is nothing but it is a rectangular hyperbola. This is the curve on y-axis. We plot speed, and whereas in x-axis we represent armature current, and if we draw a curve it will be like this. During initial conditions, that is when the armature current is very low, the speed will be very high. As the armature currents go on increasing, the speed gets decreased. This curve is called as rectangular hyperbola. During heavy load, the armature current IA is large and the speed is low. At light load, or if there is no load on the DC series motor, then it draws a small amount of current, which results in a high speed. Hence, series motors are never started without load. Okay, always series motors should be started with load. If we start the series motor with no load means it attains a dangerous high speed. So always the DC motor should be started on load. And this DC series motor is a variable speed motor. Now let us see the other type of characteristics, that is the mechanical characteristics. And these mechanical characteristics is drawn between speed and armature torque. And these characteristics will be similar to speed versus armature current characteristics. And these are below, I will show the characteristics curve. And this curve shows that as the torque increases, the speed decreases. And series motors are used where the motors are directly coupled to the load, such as in electric traction. Where the speed falls as the torque gets increased. And this is the speed versus armature torque characteristic curves. On y-axis, speed is plotted, and on x-axis armature torque is plotted. When we draw a curve between these N and TA, the curve will be like this. And this curve is exactly similar to the previous one. This curve is called as rectangular hyperbola. Here, during the initial period, the speed will be high, and the armature torque will be low. As the armature torque goes on increasing, the speed gets decreased. Now, let us study about the characteristics of DC shunt motor. Till now, we have studied about DC series motor characteristics. From now, these curves represents the characteristics of DC shunt motor. In this, the first characteristic curve is the electrical characteristics, which is drawn between armature torque and armature current. Here we assume the flux phi to be constant. So, as the flux phi is constant, the armature torque will be directly proportional to armature current. If we draw characteristics between TA and IA, then we get a straight line which is passing through the origin. And the heavy starting load will need a heavy starting current. And the shunt motor should never be started on load. Their series motor should be started on load. It is mandatory. And here the shunt motor should not be started on heavy load. And the curve between TA and IA will be a straight line, because TA is directly proportional to IA. And here this dotted line represents the shaft torque shown as TSH. And the next characteristics is N versus IA, means speed versus armature current characteristics. As we have assumed the flux phi to be constant, so EB is also practically constant, and the speed is directly proportional to the back EMF EB. So the speed of the DC shunt motor is treated as constant. But whereas in practical condition, the speed gets reduced to a little bit because the flux and back EMF varies slightly with the load. Now and the speed variation always depends on magnetic saturation of poles, armature reaction, and also on brush position. So it has a slight drooping characteristics. And these motors can be used where loads are totally and suddenly thrown off without resulting in excessive speed. Now let us see the curve between N and IA. As I have already said, the speed will be constant irrespective of the armature current. But in practical conditions, the speed gets reduced a little bit like this. It will not be exactly constant, but it will be a little bit less. Now let us study the mechanical characteristics of DC shunt motor, which is between speed N and armature torque TA or gross torque. From these characteristics, it can be observed that the speed falls as the load torque increases, and the shunt motor is approximately constant speed motor. And if we know this characteristics, then it will be very easy to determine which type of motor will be suitable to drive a given load. Now let us see the characteristics between N and armature torque. It will be like this. Means the speed gets reduced to a very little bit. Here the dotted line indicates an idle condition, and the green line indicates the practical condition. From this presentation, we have learned about the electrical and mechanical characteristics of a DC series motor, and also we have studied about the characteristics of DC shunt motor. Now let us see a small quiz on this presentation. First question is, running the machine at no load is not advisable for option A, DC series motor, option B, DC shunt motor, option C, three phase induction motor, and option D is none of the above. Come on, think, what is the answer? Yes, the answer is option A. A DC series motor should not be run at no load. And the next question is, the armature torque versus armature current graph of a DC series motor is a straight line throughout, option B, parabola throughout, option C, parabola up to magnetic saturation, and straight line, option D, is hyperbola. Yes, the answer is yes, C, parabola up to magnetic saturation and straight line after that. Now let us see the third one. As the load is increased, the speed of a DC motor increases proportionally, remains constant, increases slightly, reduces slightly. What is the answer? Yes, the answer is reduces slightly. Now the fourth question is, a DC series motor is best suited for electric traction as it develops high starting torque, it consumes less power, it is cheaper in cost, none of the above. A DC motor is best suited for traction because of its high starting torque. The next one, when an electric train is moving down a hill, the DC motor will operate as a DC, option A, series motor, option B, DC series generator, option C, shunt motor, option D, shunt generator. The answer is series generator. Now let us see some frequently asked questions. First one is, explain the electrical and mechanical characteristics of DC series motor. And also explain the electrical and mechanical characteristics of DC shunt motor. Why DC series motor is having high starting torque? And the fourth one is, draw the curves for A, torque versus current, B, torque versus speed of DC shunt motor, option 5, draw the curves for torque versus current, torque versus speed for DC series motor. Thank you very much for listening.